Hello all, I am Snehalata Jadhav from KNBC College Gurdwari, affiliated to Solapur University, Solapur. Today I will be talking about antimicrobial drugs. This particular topic is included in BSc third year syllabus in the paper of medical microbiology as unit number 5. Antimicrobial drugs are chemicals that are used to treat microbial infections. Before antimicrobials, large number of people died from common illnesses. Now, many illnesses can easily be treated with antimicrobials. However, many antimicrobial drugs are less useful due to various reasons, and one of the major reasons is emergence of drug resistance. Antimicrobial drugs are chemotherapeutic agents. They are taken in similar context as chemotherapeutic agents. There are different types of antimicrobial drugs as antibacterial drugs, antifungal drugs, antiprotozoan drugs, antihelminthic drugs, and antiviral drugs. This is a table of terminologies which are related to this topic, term and definition. Students can copy this table from the presentation given or can take this table down. The first scientist which made this breakthrough of antimicrobial agents is Paul Ehrlich. He observed that certain dyes stain bacterial cells and not animal cells. So that was the chemical staining or selectively bacterial stains. So he theorized that there could be a dye or chemical that would harm only bacterial cells but not human cells. And a systematic search was put forth for research of chemical to cure syphilis. Of all the compounds he tested, the 606 compound tested proved to be highly effective in treating laboratory animals. So you can see the effort put on the scientists to search the medicines we are easily getting from medical stores nowadays. There is huge effort to search a single compound. You can relate this with the antiviral drugs against COVID-19, as it has been 6 months and there are very less number of chemicals which can be given a sure shot remedy for COVID-19. Then there comes the Gerhard Domag. He discovered a red dye named as protoncil, which was effective in treating streptococcal infections in animals. But this dye showed no effect in test tube. So this was something interesting. It was theorized that enzymes in animal blood split protoncil molecule into sulfanilamide. This acted against streptococcal bacteria, and thus sulfa drugs were discovered. And then comes in the picture the great Alexander Fleming. While working on the cultures of staphylococcus, there was a contamination of mold on his plate. He noticed colonies growing near mold looked odd. He found that mold was secreting substance that was killing bacteria. So this is a typical colony of Alexander Fleming. You can see a penicillium colony, and you can see growth of inhibition around the penicillium colony, and there is normal bacterial colonies which are seen growing far from the penicillium colony. So Sir Alexander Fleming, he was the first to discover antibiotics. Antibiotics are often taken in similar context with antimicrobial drugs, but that is not the case. Antibiotics are different, and Sir Alexander Fleming, after the discovery of Sir Alexander Fleming, there was a revolution in medical. We can see n number of antibiotics which are available in the market, and patients are being treated with different antibiotics. Then comes the topic of features of antimicrobial drugs. Most modern antibiotics come from species of microorganisms that lie in the soil. Yes, soil. Because soil is said to be godown of microorganisms, and we can see vast diversity of microorganisms present in soil. But to commercially produce an antibiotic, we must select a strain and grow in broth. The strain must be able to produce antibiotic. When maximum antibiotic concentration is reached, extract this antibiotic from medium. Then we have to purify it, and maybe this can be chemically altered to make a more stable antibiotic, and after passing various quality control issues, it can be given as a medicine. We must know what is selective toxicity when we look at antimicrobial drugs or antibiotics. It must cause greater harm to microorganism than host, that is humans. Then there is a concept of chemotherapeutic index, which is defined as lowest dose toxic to patient divided by dose typically used for therapy. We have to balance efficacy and toxicity. We cannot give highest doses of antibiotics or antimicrobial drugs. There has to be a limitation, and therefore there comes the therapeutic index. Then comes the topic of antimicrobial action. There are two major antimicrobial action. One is bacteriostatic and another is bactericidal. Bacteriostatic antibiotics, they are responsible for inhibiting the growth of microorganisms, while bactericidal antibiotics, they actually kill the microorganisms. Then we must know what is spectrum of activity. Antimicrobial medications vary with respect to range of microorganisms they kill or inhibit. Some kill only limited range, they are called as narrow spectrum antibiotics or antimicrobial agent, while other kills wide range of microorganisms, they are called as broad spectrum antimicrobial agents. So here is an example of various antibiotics and their spectrum of activity. The best known first antibiotic is penicillin, which we can say that it's a narrow spectrum antibiotic which is effective against gram-positive bacteria and very small number of gram-negative bacteria and chlamydia. Whereas tetracyclines are effective against gram-positive bacteria, gram-negative bacteria, chlamydia and rickettsia. Here is a list of different antibiotics, known antibiotics. You can compare the arrows to know the spectrum of activity. Tetracyclines are called as broad spectrum antibiotics, and polymyxins or vancomycins are called as narrow spectrum antibiotics. Antibiotics are often combined to give better results, but we cannot combine various antibiotics randomly. There is a concept known as synergistic action. There is action of one drug enhances the activity of another, and there is also a concept called as antagonistic, where activity of one drug interferes with the action of another. Then adverse effect. Antibiotics are capable of giving allergic reactions. Some people develop hypersensitivities to antimicrobials. Then there are toxic effects. As we are talking about selective toxicity, basically antibiotics are toxins. So some antimicrobials are capable of giving poisonous effects to the host, and we cannot use higher concentrations as they can cause adverse effects. Also, they are known to be suppressing normal flora. Normal flora is very essential for normal functioning of human beings. So if they harm normal flora, it has to be replenished by some means. So here was the introduction of antimicrobial drugs. We must know the properties. We have talked about this already. Selective toxicity, the antibiotic must be selectively toxic against the pathogen which is targeted and not against host. So we must know the concept of LD50. What is LD50? It is to be high and minimal inhibitory concentration or minimal bactericidal concentration to be low. LD50 is lethal dose 50, that is a measure of drug toxicity or lethality against host. LD50 is measured as the toxic dose which is capable of killing or inhibiting 50% of population is called as LD50. MIC, that is minimal inhibitory concentration, it is measure of concentration of antibiotic necessary to inhibit growth of the target pathogen. And MBC, which is taken in similar context as MIC, it is measure of concentration of antibiotic necessary to kill the target pathogen. Then antibiotic must have a favorable pharmacokinetics, that is survive in high concentration and reach the target site, that is infection, where infection actually occurs. As in COVID-19 case, the infection is in lungs. So if we take antibiotics through mouth, the effective concentration must reach to the lungs and inside the cells of the lungs so that the antimicrobial agent would actually act against that virus. So pharmacokinetics is action of drugs in the body over a period of time, including absorption. So when we consume the drug, it has to be absorbed properly. Distribution, it has to be circulated properly in circulation, localization in the tissues, that is where actually infection is there, and biotransformation, that is biochemical alterations which are supposed to occur inside the body or inside the cells. And then when the function is over, the function of the antimicrobial agents is over, it is supposed to be excreted. All of the antibiotic we have taken is supposed to be excreted outside the body. This is important because it cannot remain in our body for a long period of time because it is actually a poison or toxin. So this is a favorable pharmacokinetics. The drug should be bactericidal or bacteriostatic. In case of bacteria, the spectrum of activity should be as per required. For example, a broad spectrum antibiotic would be indicated against polymicrobial infection, for example, an intra-abdominal anaerobic infection where the target organism or infectious agent is not exactly known. And a narrow spectrum antibiotic would be ideal for an infection caused by a single pathogen. Example is staphylococcal skin infection. So skin ointments are formulated with only one antibiotic, which is narrow spectrum. Then the antibiotic must lack of side effects and it must be able to cross outer cytoplasmic membranes. This is important for antimicrobial agents to give its antimicrobial action. No or low level of antibiotic resistance in target pathogen should be there. So as antibiotic resistance is an emerging problem, most recent problem for the microbiology, then lack of cross resistance and closely related strain should be present so as to be antibiotic would be more effective. And it must be resistant to the inactivation by microbial enzymes. If we give antibiotic to a patient and patient infectious agent is inactivating the antibiotic, then we could see no results. This is a form of drug resistance. I told you earlier that there is a difference between antibiotic and antimicrobial agents. Antibiotic is basically of microbial origin. An antibiotic also is a selective poison. It has been chosen so that it will kill the desired bacteria but not the cells in your body. Each different type of antibiotic affects different bacteria in different ways. For example, an antibiotic might inhibit a bacteria's ability to turn glucose into energy or the bacteria's ability to construct its cell wall. Therefore, the bacteria dies instead of reproducing. There are different types of antimicrobial agents. Some of them inhibit cell wall synthesis. This is called as mechanism of action. Mechanism of action against cell wall synthesis, against protein synthesis, against nucleic acid synthesis, and some of them also cause injury to plasma membrane of the infectious agent, and some of them inhibit synthesis of essential metabolites. So here is a diagram of antimicrobial agents which are interfering with the metabolism of common pathogen. You can take this down or memorize it well. We can see some antibiotic can act on replication, transcription, transition, and an inhibition of nucleic acid synthesis and enzymatic activity. The antibiotics which are known to be acting on cell wall synthesis are penicillins, cephalosporins, bacitracins, and vancomycins. Antibiotics which act against protein synthesis are chloramphenicol, erythromycins, tetracyclines, and streptomycins. Then antibiotics which act against replication are quinolones and rifampicin, and antibiotics which act against enzymatic activity of the target pathogen are sulfonamides and trimethoprim. Then some antibiotics also cause injury to plasma membrane. One of them is polymyxin B. So this is all about introduction of antimicrobial agents. Thank you.